Hi, I'm Cisco with ACROBOTIC, and today we're going to be talking about how to get started with the ESP8266 development board. We're going to be using the Arduino IDE to write custom firmware that is going to be downloaded onto the board and execute. The materials that we're going to need for this tutorial are the development board itself. It's optional, but nice to have a solderless breadboard and just a micro B USB cable. We've taken the ESP12E module, mounted it on our development board in order to make things even easier. We include a few additional components like a USB to serial UART translator chip by Silicon Labs and a few other, like a voltage regulator, a few other components so that you can just plug it into your computer, use the Arduino IDE and just get started with developing software or firmware that will run on the ESP8266 itself. There are a few different options that you can use for developing firmware that will run on your ESP8266. And we're gonna be using today the Arduino IDE, but I wanted to mention the two more popular ones are using AT commands. This is where you hook up the ESP8266 to a microcontroller. Typically, that microcontroller will send this AT commands via a serial UART interface. And again, you can read a little bit more on the links included in the description, but then the ESP8266 device is just listening to AT commands, and then you tell it using an AT sequence, hey, connect to Wi-Fi, this is my SSID, etc., etc. We're not gonna be using that. We're gonna write custom firmware that will get uploaded to the ESP8266, and the ESP8266 is just gonna run that custom firmware. The other one that is really, really popular is the NodeMCU firmware. That's a little bit similar to the AT commands. You can actually use it a few different ways, but for the most part, you end up using the Lua programming language to have this sort of live interaction with the ESP8266 itself. You can read more about it again in the links included in the description, but in order to get started with the Arduino IDE, we're gonna jump to the arduino.cc website and we're gonna go to the download section. And this is in case you don't have the Arduino IDE already installed. For those of you who are not familiar, IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. So we're gonna look for the latest version, which is at the day of this recording, 1.6.7. I'm gonna be using a Mac, so I'm gonna click on the link for Mac OS X. And then, you know, I encourage you to contribute to the project. They're doing really great work. I'm just for now gonna click just download, and it should take a couple of minutes to download depending on your internet connection. The second piece of software that we're gonna need is actually the drivers for talking to the IC that is on our development board that does the USB to serial UART translation. And for that, we're gonna go to the link from Scilabs, Silicon Labs, included in the description of this video. And for me, again, I'm running this on a Mac, running OS X, so I'm gonna scroll down and I'm gonna download the VCP drivers for Mac OS X. And depending on your operating system, you'll need to download the corresponding drivers. Once you've downloaded the VCP drivers from the Silicon Labs website, go ahead and double click on the file. Then go to the mounted image and double click on the package file to go through the installation process. Go ahead and click continue. If you want, read the software license agreement for it. Once you agree with it, then click agree if you agree. And then just click on install. It'll ask you to enter your password as you're going through the process. This is, again, just installing the drivers that you'll need in order to communicate with the development board. And it takes a few seconds to install. At the same time, we can go through the process of installing the Arduino development environment. So I'm gonna go back to my downloads, which is where I downloaded the file. I'm gonna go ahead and unzip it. And that process should take a little bit. Once the application is unzipped, go ahead and drag it to your applications folder. And I had a previous installation. I'm just gonna go ahead and replace that one. Once the VCP drivers are installed, you're pretty much ready to go. You can go ahead and open the Arduino IDE. Then we want to go through the file menu for Windows users and through preferences menu for Mac users. There's gonna be an additional board manager URLs entry. Go ahead and enter the URL included in the description of this video. And if you already have URLs on there, then just go ahead and add a comma and a space before adding the one for the ESP8266 family of boards. You click OK. The reason we did that is in order to have the boards recognized automatically by the IDE without installing anything additional. Then we can go through the Tools menu, go to Boards and Boards Manager. We want to search for ESP8266, click on the entry and click on Install. It'll download a few things and install a few others, so it'll take some time. Once that's completed, we want to close down the Arduino app or the Arduino IDE app and restart it. Once all of this is done, you can go ahead and connect your development board, your ESP8266 development board, to the USB port of your computer. From the Tools menu, we're going to select Board and the NodeMCU 1.0 entry. And for the port, we're going to select, for Mac, it looks like the one I'm showing on screen, is /dev/cu.slab for Silicon Labs USB to UART. On Windows, it'll be COM and a number. So you just go ahead and select the entry. And then finally, we can go through the file menu, examples, basics, and we're gonna open the program Blink. Then we're gonna make a few modifications so that it works with the ESP8266 board. Instead of the number 13 for the pin that we're going to be using, we're gonna be changing it to pin number 16. Then we can go ahead and click the upload button. And your board should start blinking once the program is uploaded to the ESP8266. So that's it. You're ready to get started writing your own firmware to the ESP8266. Thank you for watching.